Hi, did you know functions let you simplify and automate redundant tasks? In this video, let's learn about functions and how to utilize them across different instances in an application. A function is a set of statements or a block of code that takes inputs, performs operations, and delivers the results as output. Syntax of function: return type space function name argument. Return type: a function returns output in different data types. We refer to this as the return type. These are the list of return types supported in Zoho Creator. Sometimes, there can be situations where a function may be required to do an operation but won't return any output. In those cases, void can be used. Function name. It's the name we assign to a function. Arguments. Arguments are the input values that we sent into the function. These values can be of any data types like we mentioned earlier. We can also pass multiple arguments to a function at a time. Let's consider functions using a basic example. This function returns an integer. We have specified the return number as 10, and while executing it, we have given the input argument number as 100. Thus, the output will be 100 plus 10 equals 110. Next, we'll see the types of functions. There are two types of functions in Creator. Built-in function. Instead of writing a code for simple tasks, these predefined actions can be used for tasks like checking for the length of the word, or for a blank value, or for more such common tasks. Check the link in the description box to learn more about built-in functions. Custom function. In contrast to built-in functions, custom functions let you define logic to meet a specific requirement as per your need. In this demonstration, we'll use the leave tracker application to learn how functions work. We have two forms named employees and leave count. The employee form will have the employee details and the leave count form containing all employees' leave data. Assume we have a requirement to reset the allotted leaves of all employees at the beginning of every calendar year. This can be achieved in two simple steps. 1. Create function to update the leave count. 2. Run a schedule to execute the function. Let's proceed to create a function. From the editor, go to the workflow section, choose functions, and click on new function. Name the function. Creator gives you the flexibility to define a function in multiple languages such as Node.js, Java, and Deluge. Let's go with Deluge for this demo. Choose the namespace as default. Namespaces can be considered as folders where you could group similar functions. You can create a namespace if needed or set it as default. Our function will not return any data type, so let it be void. Arguments, also known as inputs to the function, should be specified here. It can be of any data type. In our case, we'll skip the argument as the function does not return any data. It runs the function and executes it to update the leaves of the employees. Proceed to create a function, the Deluge builder will open. Type record equals leave count ID not equal to 0. This makes sure to update all the records in the leave count form as no records will have ID as 0. Then use for each record task to go through all the records of leave count form where employees ID is not equal to 0. Then use if condition to specify the leave count based on the gender of the employee. Type if record.employees.gender equals female. Record.casualleave equals 12, record.sickleave equals 12, and record.maternityleave equals 180, semicolon. Type an else condition to specify the leave count for the male employees. Copy and paste the same and change the maternity leave count to 0 as it will not be applicable to male employees. Click Save. We have now created a function. Creator gives you the flexibility to test the function soon after creating it. Before we trigger the function, let's take a look at the leave report. The current report shows a different leave count for employees. On executing the function, the leave count will be reset. Let's trigger the function now. And now the report shows the updated leave count. You may wonder if the function trigger has to happen manually every time. As mentioned earlier, functions can be used in different workflows you create. In this scenario, We could automate the leave reset process by creating a schedule workflow to execute this function periodically. Let's see how it can be done. From the editor, proceed to create a workflow on a scheduled date. Choose a start date and time. Choose a runtime as yearly, as the update has to occur every year. Name the workflow and click Create. Click Add New Action and choose Deluge Script, then the builder will open. We have already defined a function UpdateEmployee. Using the call function Deluge Task, you can call a function in your app. The call function task allows you to invoke the function from the same or different app in your account. To invoke from the same application, use the syntax thisApp.functionName open close bracket semicolon. In case you're invoking the function from a different app, then use the syntax applicationLinkName.functionName open close bracket semicolon. Our requirement is to invoke the function within the app. For this, type thisApp. And you will get listed with functions in that app if you have any. Next, type the function name UpdateEmployeeLeave. Add a semicolon, click Save, and close the builder. This workflow will automatically run every year on the specified date and time, and the associated function will get executed. This is one example of where we can call a function. You can call functions from form workflows for sending bulk mail reminders, report workflows, run a function on report by creating a customized button, execute it from functions as well. You can execute simple tasks from functions itself. Advantages of using functions. You don't have to create a function every time. Create it once and use it in various places. This way, you can save time. Irrespective of the app where it was created, you can call from any application. Deluge is a scripting language that has no code complexity. So, the modularity makes it easier to debug. You can call a function inside another function if there's a requirement. From sending an email or notifications to creating an automatic course of actions that must occur at frequent intervals, functions make those easier for various tasks. That's all for today. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about Zoho Creator and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in another video.